Today's Spotlight is brought to you in part by presenting sponsor, Busey Bank. Busey, your dream, our promise.
If you're just tuning in, you're watching Spotlight. I'm your host, Jane Wernette, and joining me now from the Naperville Astronomical Association are Eric Clays and Susan Wilson. So thank you for coming
and
welcome to the set. It's always good to have you back, and I'm going to start not with you, Eric, this time. I'm going to start with Susan. How did you get interested in astronomy?
Well, I got interested in astronomy when I was pretty young. My dad used to sit on the back patio on nice, warm summer evenings, and he would point out the stars to me. And then he would take me to the planetarium at the local nature center. And then in high school, I got really interested, and I made my own telescope, ground my own optic, and then had the aluminum put on it. And so I am the proud owner of a handmade Newtonian telescope.
Awesome!
Yeah,
that's so great.
Yeah.
So it was really, it's just always been there for you. As a child, your dad got you engaged, and it's something that stayed with you?
Yes, and then I went to school in astronomy, and there were a lot of gals that were in astronomy at the University of Arizona where I went, and it was a lot of opportunities to go to the big telescopes there and to see, you know, Kitt Peak and the multiple mirror telescope. So it was really excellent.
That's wonderful.
Yeah.
That's one, and I'm not sure that I would have known. Is Arizona a place that typically a lot of people do go?
It is the U.S.'s premier astronomical university.
Okay.
And they also have a mirror lab there where they make all the really, really large telescope optics. So it's a good optics school as well as astronomy school.
Okay.
Yeah.
Now, what did you do with that afterwards?
There aren't a lot of jobs for astronomers.
Okay, I was just curious.
Right. So then I went on into engineering because I wanted to be in optics. And so I continued in optics and I got a PhD in engineering. And I actually right now am involved with optics and polishing mirrors even to this day.
So it's carried all the way through from early childhood. That's an awesome story. I love that.
Thanks.
Eric, now, since you were last here with your giant telescope, I'm missing a little bit here, tell us a little bit about what the club's been involved in. What's new and what are you doing?
Okay. So since the last time I was here, we've started doing family-friendly events. So in the summer, we have a program we call Fundamentals. It's kind of more of a how to do this, how to do that. So we started doing things for families and kids. So for instance, how do craters on the moon form? So we actually will have a big bucket with flour in there and a little cocoa, and kids will drop a marble, and they'll see what looks like a crater. So we have a bunch of hands-on stuff, so family stuff. We did that in June, and we're doing that again next week. The other big thing is we're getting much larger crowds than we used to get. So two examples. At our last family event, we had about 115 people show up.
That's great.
At the thing. Typically, we get about 50 show up at a meeting. At our last event at the observatory, we had 215. Our prior record was 150 last year. 2 years ago, when I was first on, we would get maybe 30 or 40 people to come. And
that's
consider
incredible.
That a good night. So I think being on this show, we've been in several newspaper articles, stuff like that, I think is really helping. We also have a Facebook page, which we have a lot of people following us. So we actually get people coming out to the Riverwalk because they saw us on Facebook. So they knew we were going to be there.
Okay.
So that's really nice. It's nice to get to a lot more people in the community that way.
So, and it sounds like maybe that interest, much maybe like Susan, that interest has been there, but they didn't know you were around.
I think that's very true. And it's really cool with the family stuff. You of course have moms and dads with their kids. They want to have their kids learn something. And we're able to teach even the 5-year-old kids, we can teach them something.
Yeah.
And hopefully get them excited into astronomy or some science.
Well, it's the great undiscovered, isn't it? And that, there's a lot of interest in that.
Well, and everybody reads Goodnight Moon to their kid. Well, why not show the moon to your kid, right?
So very true.
Yeah.
So very true.
Yeah. Yeah.
Now, this is a lot of outreach stuff that you're doing into the community, but what are some of the things that you have for just the members of the clubs? What kind of events and activities?
So we have three things. So we have an observatory, and members, we have a members night, so only members and a guest of the member can come. So there might be, say, 20 people rather than 200. And we will bring our scopes and we'll talk amongst ourselves, stuff like that. We also have three dark sites that we can go to. As club members, you're given their directions. So you can actually see the Milky Way there. Of course, in Naperville, you can't see very much.
Right. Too much ambient light.
Yes. Too much, yeah. So those dark sites. And then certain members, if they're trained, they can actually get a key to our observatory, so they can go anytime they want on their own and use one of the observatories. Those are kind of the three main things as a member you can do that the public can't do.
Okay, that's wonderful. Now, where's the observatory? Can we disclose that information?
Oh, yeah. Yes, because it's behind a gate. Plainfield, Naperville Road, south of 95th. There's a water treatment plant. We're literally on their lot, so you have to go through their gate, which is typically closed.
Okay.
So that and coming up real soon, there's a whole bunch of planets that are visible in the night sky towards the end of this month. And so people need to get out there, and they can see a lot of the planets
that you wouldn't otherwise. I mean, it's
you wouldn't normally see them, right?
It's timing.
Yeah. Yes. And these are all going to be, you'll be able to see them all in one evening.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Wow. In one night?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Which is that's pretty rare.
Yeah. It's right.
It's a little bit like the whole when we had the eclipse, right? I mean, that's when people really start to get interested when they see
it's
those amazing.
It's a very unique event that's happening.
Right.
Yeah. But we did get this one person came and visited the club, and she said, "How can you guys always look at the same thing over and over?" And I've been thinking about that question, and I realized, well, it's just like anything that you're interested in. You know, when I look through a telescope, it's the most beautiful sight when you're seeing galaxies, nebulas, star clusters. They are just gorgeous. They're just like jewels in the night sky. How would you not want to go back and look at those things over and over again?
So true. Yeah. So true. I'm going to ask a question, and I hope you want to take offense, but how many women are involved? Because it's something I know, Eric, we talked about before, but how do you find that? Do you get lots more women involved than you used to? Less?
Actually, I'd say it's less.
Okay.
Like I said, when I was at school, there were a huge number of women that were involved in astronomy and very active. And in a lot of the clubs, it does tend to, somehow we miss out on the women. And I would like them to, like, give it a try. Like, if you're interested as a child, come back to it now. And we're very friendly. And there are women that are there. And, you know, we interact with each other. And the club is just, you know, very engaging, and we have amazing speakers. We had a speaker last night that gave us a whole wonderful talk about the different NASA. Well, it was actually a thing about NASA versus SpaceX, you know, it was a comparison.
Okay.
And, you know, Elon Musk right now, he runs SpaceX, and they're doing, you know, Jeff Bezos has a group for Blue Origin. And so they're getting more and more young people really excited about, you know, we can actually get a lot more rockets going up and send a lot more payloads and satellites. And I think, if anything, women need to be a part of that, you know?
And welcomed at the club.
Yes.
Which I know that they are. I know Eric and, you know, has come back and they're always so welcoming. So.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah, they are.
Yeah.
Yeah, definitely.
That's wonderful. Well, certainly, I wish you all the best with the stuff that you have coming up. I encourage the viewers to go check you out because I know that you've got lots of stuff that not only works for the members, but also on that community outreach if you just want to engage, right, in some events. It's there for you.
Yes.
So
thank
you so much for coming by. And if you would like to learn more about the Naperville Astronomical Association, please go and visit their website. We're going to take a quick break. Stay tuned. We're coming right back with more Spotlight.